Any clue as to who wanted to make Hebrew an official American language? Why does the official seal of Yale feature a biblical term in Hebrew? Which colleges in America made Hebrew a mandatory course for their students? During the early years of colonial America, familiarity with the Hebrew language was common among the intelligentsia and the clergy. The first 10 colleges founded in the colonies all offered courses in Hebrew, which was the preferred language for studying the Bible. Valedictory addresses at Harvard, Yale, and other institutions of higher learning were offered in Hebrew, and the official seal of Yale and Columbia universities, as well as Dartmouth College, featured biblical terms in Hebrew. Professors, intellectuals, clergy, and elected officials took active roles in the Hebraist movement, which aimed to make Hebrew an official U.S. language. The first two presidents of Harvard University, Increase Mather and Samuel Langdon, proposed to make Hebrew an official language in the new colonies. At Yale, Ezra Stiles, the university's seventh president, spoke, read, and taught Hebrew. He corresponded with Hebron Rabbi Chaim Karigal with the aim of basing the U.S. law on the Ten Commandments. He noted that Moses assembled 3 million people, the number of Americans in 1776, urging graduate students to be able to recite Psalm in Hebrew. Samuel Johnson, founder and first president of King's College, which later became Columbia University, instigated Hebrew as a mandatory course. He claimed that Hebrew is essential to a gentleman's education, and both of his sons were fluent in Hebrew. Many Hebrew words have found their way into the English language. For instance, abracadabra consists of two Hebrew words that mean I shall create as I speak. Amen means faith in Hebrew. Hallelujah is another Hebrew word meaning praise God. Chutzpah means audacity, and kosher means fit for use. These are just a few of many examples. The Hebrew roots in the history of the United States have produced a deep affinity by most Americans towards the revival of the Hebrew language and the reconstruction of the Jewish Commonwealth in the land of Israel. Thank you for watching. This video is the third in a series of 9 displaying the unique bond between Israel and the United States. We'll be right back.